WeatherLab. Here's Rob's forecast.
Welcome back. Well, good looking weather over the next couple of days. Doesn't get much better for early spring. We'll be warming up toward the weekend, and with that, some clouds as well. We'll take a look at that latest long range model coming up in just a little bit. But the weekend not looking too bad, and this past one wasn't too bad, although there was severe weather to the west, to the north, and just to the east of us this past weekend. Not expecting that though this weekend. So big picture, as we see what's going on across the lower 48, and you see on the wind particles, you can see that purple. That's some gusty winds there following the storm system on the East Coast that has been a severe weather producer over the last 3 days. Meanwhile, energy shifting back to the west. Some big rains on the way. Got snow advisories at elevation across the Sierra Nevada, and then flood and flash flood watches going. We're expecting 3 to 5 inches of rain here over the next couple of days, mainly just north of the LA area, but that's too much rain for the desert southwest. So they are going to have some flooding and some mudslides over the next 24 to 36 hours, perhaps a little bit more, but better yet, some good moisture getting into the Sierra Nevada to feed the crops across much of the nation's breadbasket there in California. Meanwhile, as we look into the Midwest and the Northeast, oh my goodness, it's still snow. First day of spring, and Mother Nature, a little bit of a sick sense of humor here, and more snow will be piling up through the Northeast all the way up through New England. With that storm system, same storm system that produced all the severe weather. Well, things have quieted down with respect to severe storms after some strong ones moved through the Carolinas all the way down through South Florida. Things have quieted down here and locally. We cannot complain. Fair skies, just got some high level cirrus clouds streaming across the area, and then we might see that from time to time next couple of days. Temperatures today started out in the lower 50s across Acadiana. We got up into the upper 60s, and now we're sitting mostly in the 50s offshore. It's been rough out here, but settling down over the next couple of days. Some good weather for fishing, and I hear the specks are running no matter all the sandy effluent and muddy effluent we have coming out of the Atchafalaya River. So thanks to Don Moe and his friends down towards Sycamore Point. I got that through Facebook. High pressure looking right in charge for tomorrow. Once again, wall-to-wall sunshine, and then going into Thursday, much the same, although the high pressure begins to push off to the east. We'll start to see that return flow, so we'll be a little bit milder Thursday afternoon, but still a cool start and a mild finish. And then as we get closer to the weekend, we're going to see those southerly winds kick in, and that means warmer temperatures for sure on the way. Here's a quick look at the European model showing the next storm system and another snowstorm, that same storm moving through the northeast down the line. Tail end of the frontal boundary gets close to us as we get into the latter part of the weekend, but we're going to keep rain chance at the 10% range for Saturday and also for Palm Sunday here. And then moving into next week, it's going to get stormy in the nation's midsection. We're going to have to watch this water because it's going to get into the Red River and the Mississippi River. But it looks like highest rain chances just to the north and west of us until the latter part of next week. That's when it may get stormy. We'll have to wait and see on that. 9-10 days down the road is still fairy tale land. So temperatures tonight, low to mid 40s. So nice and fresh out there. To I-10 corridor, we'll be in the mid 40s for sure. And then much the same along the coast. It may take a degree or two off some of these numbers, except Cameron by the water, a little bit milder. And then tomorrow after that cool start, we'll get back into the upper 60s. We'll touch 70 briefly for the afternoon high. Tomorrow night, back down into the low to mid 40s, and then going into Thursday afternoon, pushing into the lower 70s. So jackets and sweaters for sure. First thing tomorrow morning, not as breezy, but there's still a little breeze out there tonight. 46 the low, 70 the high tomorrow. Another gorgeous day. North to northwest winds at about 8 to 14. And as we move down the road into the weekend, temperatures warming up into the mid 70s toward the end of the week and back into the low to mid 80s this weekend. Rain chances 10%, but we're not including them in the 10-day forecast. Rain chances gradually going upward as we get deeper into next week. But this week, good times to be the meteorologist.